Welcome to this new add-on spotlight. In this add-on spotlight, we're going to look at Volanta, which is a tool which has been released by ORBX. And the tool has several options. It has the option to, I would say, schedule a flight, keep track of your flights, add some more aircrafts, although that's a more an option to make it easier to schedule your flights. And it also contains challenges. So we're going to look at the first option, which is schedule a flight. So the airplane is currently located at Amsterdam Schiphol Airport. I created a flight plan using the built-in Microsoft Flight Simulator flight planning tool, but Volanta also has some other options, and let's have a look at them. So what you can do is you can import a file, you can paste a route, and import a file is really creating a flight plan, for example, with Flight Simulator and then importing it here, or you can use SimBrief. Right, so if you're if you want to use SimBrief, you see it here, you need to define a destination. So let's do that. So plan is to fly to Trondheim. You can see it's now not grayed out anymore. So you'll hit the button and then it will come with the known window to select the airplane. And then if you're using it for the first time, it will ask you for your username and password, of course. And once you provided that, it will generate the plan automatically. So there are now options here to go to the briefing, and that will simply bring you to the location of SimBrief and will show the PDF file which is generated, which contains the flight plan on and all the relevant information. And you've got pre-file, which shows several other options, such as that you can pre-file it to VetSim, which is another tool or add-on which you can use to, I would say, make Flight Simulator even more professional, because you need to really follow the official rules which are applicable to flying around the world. Once that's done, right, you can start flying using Flight Simulator. It keeps track of the altitude, the headings, the ground speed, and the time remaining, and the estimated arrival time. And once you are flying, it will also show you the altitude, increase, decrease, etc., which is cool. So that's the first thing you can do with Volanta. The other thing you can do is you can review the flights you already performed. So in my case, I performed a flight at the Ford Island Naval Auxiliary Landing Field, and I make some turns, and then I landed again. And it shows me, okay, hey, this was the flight time, this was the date of the flight, the fuel burn, the number of passengers, and this was the altitude, right? So I climbed and then I flew back and landed at the airport. Then we've got the aircraft option, and the aircraft option is auto-populated based on the airplane you're selecting in Flight Simulator. So currently I only have flown with the C-172 and the A320. So what you need to do is you need to select the airplane which you want to fly with, and then it will automatically populate that once you're in the airport and have pressed the ready to fly button. Then a cool feature, which is the country challenge, and the country challenge has different types of challenges. For example, it has, okay, hey, you need to fly to Dubrovnik and use the VOR for runway 29. But it also has options or challenges, I should say, flying from Miami to Ibiza, right? So all cool features. As you can see, currently there are 246 challenges in Flight Simulator, or three. Yeah, you visited zero of the 246 countries, I should say it like that. And you can see already a lot of challenges have been added here. Probably they will add some more challenges in the future. So what are the other options you can do? Well, if you go to the settings, you can enable multi-factor authentication. It's recommended to do that to secure your account. If you don't like to use Volanta anymore, you can delete the account. And of course, you can use it to change the password. The My Data allows you to import data from other data sources like Project Fly, multiplayer networks, and the Sim Toolkit Pro. Privacy, allows you to change your privacy settings. By default, everybody can show your profile information, and also including your the I would say the flight you already did and some other statistics and achievements. If you don't want it, change these options. The connections menu allows you to connect to several external sources like Discord, Navigraph, VetSim, Ivio, SimBrief. You can see a lot of options here. So take a look at it and decide if you want to use them. It's not mandatory to use them because it also works perfectly without them. Then we've got the general option, which gives some options to, for example, start Volanta automatically. Change the language. It's currently only available in English and German. Maybe that changes in the future. Look at the log file and check for updates. Flight planning, the known fields for which are also available in SimBrief, the briefing format and the briefing units. It's currently set to Lido and kilograms, but you can change it to either pounds or one of the various other options for the briefing format. The simulators menu, this is something you don't have to configure yourself, right? Based on the flight simulator software installed, it will automatically detect the flight simulator version which you're using, or the version, that's correct wording, yeah. And we'll configure it like here. You don't need to change anything here. Change log is really useful because you can see, okay, hey, which changes have been implemented by the team and which improvements, which bug fixes have been implemented. So really nice tool, a lot of options. So definitely one which you should put on your wish list. So here ends this video. I hope you liked the video. If you liked the video, then consider to use the like button. If you've got questions or comments, then use the comment box below the video. And if you want to see more of these videos or want to stay up to date about new videos I'm posting, then consider to subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching and see you next time.